Hello everyone, I'm Shun Technic Bricks. Today I want to show you my latest creation. This is the LiQWYD Technic 2-way to 1-way rotation converter gearbox. So basically what it does is it transfers a 2-way rotating movement to a single way rotation. But before I show you the details of this gearbox, I want to show you two other mechanisms that does the same action. I want you to know about the pros and cons of this three mechanism and why my gearbox is the best of all. So first, let me show you the most common 2-way to 1-way rotation mechanism. You can find this in a lot of books and videos. But this is also the worst of all. Let me tell you why. First, you have to know how this works. The main point is this beam tilts left and right. It can tilt to either side. Each time you spin this axle fast enough, it has friction to tilt this beam, to let the gears engage to different outputs. And second, you can see here which has 4 gears. No matter the gear ratio, but you can see 2 gears are turning clockwise and the other 2 are turning anti-clockwise. Therefore, these 2 10 gears will turn in the opposite direction. So back to this 16 tooth gear. You can see every time it tilts back and forth, it pushes this 12 tooth gear to turn. But the funny thing is, they are connected with 4 gears. When you turn this axle clockwise, the gear turns clockwise. But if you turn this axle anti-clockwise, the gear also turns clockwise. And this is very clever. But why this mechanism is bad? Let me tell you. The only worst thing is this swinging beam. You see, if you don't have enough friction, or if it's not placed horizontally, the beam doesn't tilt to the other side. That means if you turn the axle very slowly, you see it keeps on one side, and this can cause unlimited gear slippage, which this is the main problem. For this kind of mechanism, having gear slipping is the worst. And I'll consider this gearbox to have 100% gear slippage, cause it's unlimited. Which later, I'll show you how my gearbox can solve this gear slipping problem. Okay, so now I'll show you the second one. The second one is also a 2-way to 1-way rotation converter gearbox. You might know, this is a creation from LiQWYD Technic Mastery, which created a lot of cool mechanisms, and he designed this gearbox. And now I'll tell you how this mechanism works. So simply, it uses a differential gear. So the point is to let the axle rotate freely when they are spinning in the opposite direction, but also staying the 2 in or output axles still when they were turned in the same direction. So how this gearbox did it is it has a 1-way clutch on the output axle, and near the input axle, it also has a 1-way clutch. This clutch near the input allows the axle to turn clockwise. But when the axle is turned anti-clockwise, it stops the differential from turning, causing the direction change through the output axle. The best thing about this gearbox is it uses the small track piece covered around the gearbox. It works well as a 1-way clutch. But what's the cons of this gearbox? It's also the track. Let me demonstrate it to you. In here, if you put too much load, you see it cracks. It's completely destroyed. And there's no need for me to explain. But also, There's one more cons about this mechanism. It's the backlash, or you can call it gear slipping. When I was playing with it, I found out that it actually has a lot of backlash. You see here, I can just turn the output axle backwards. It might be better than the first gearbox, but it's still a big problem. I've tried and tested it many times, and I found that it has nearly 80 degrees of gear slipping backwards. So the gear slippage of this gearbox is like 33%. And I'll say this is a creative but a poor design. Okay, so for the one you've long waited. This is my creation. Again, this is the LiQWYD Technic 2-way to 1-way rotation converter gearbox created by Shun Technic Bricks. So first, I want to tell you how this gearbox works, and later I'll show you how it fixes the gear slipping problem. The first thing to know is it has the same logic as the second one, which I've shown you earlier. It uses one differential and two one-way clutches, and this one-way clutches limits the movement of the differential. The biggest change of this gearbox is the other one-way clutch, which is connected to the output axle. You can see it's simple here. These three 16 tooth gear are connected to the output axle of the one-way clutch. And this whole axle and gears connected to the input axle of the one-way clutch. I'll explain it deeply here. So when you turn this input axle, it provides friction for this differential gear to turn. But at the same time, it drives this input of the one-way clutch, which just strongly turns the output of this one-way clutch. In here, it does two actions. First, it's forced to turn by this one-way clutch. And also, its movement syncs with the input axle, so the spins in the same direction. So as I said, the biggest change is this one-way clutch. It's so simple. By using this 12 tooth gear, it has very limited gear slippage. It's just half of one tooth. Just imagine, before it turns to the next tooth, it still stays on the edge of the tooth. So the slippage of the 12 tooth gear is half a tooth. It means it's 1 out of 24 of a rotation, which has only 4% of gear slipping, and that's the best of all. And the other pros of my design is obvious. By using gears as clutch, you know that it can withstand strength. Okay, time for the cons of this gearbox. Yes, the first one is the 4% gear slippage. I think it can be fixed. But the other cons is that the output axle is connected by a lot of gears from the input axle. So yeah, the friction is quite big. I do not recommend using motors to power it. So let's sum it up. Why my gearbox is the best of all? My design has less backlash, and it can handle much torque. If you want to build this gearbox, you can get free building instructions on Rebrickable. Link in the description below. Thank you so much for paying attention. I hope you liked the video. If you do like a video, you can share it with your friends or family. Like and subscribe. If you have any question, feel free to ask in the comment section. Remember, stay safe, take care, build more LiQWYD. I'm Shun Technic Bricks, and I'll see you next time.